Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back on the Kinematic Element channel. My name is Charles Rivière. I'm a hip and knee consultant surgeon working between Bordeaux and London. I'm also part of the MSK lab, which is part of Imperial College London. Today we are going to talk about semantics. I would like to explain to you the rationale for the name of each alignment technique for knee replacement. So years ago, we did publish this classification of the multiple technique to align TKA. This year, we are going to release an update because our understanding on alignment technique has improved, and also because there is a new surgical technique which has been devised recently. So there are three systematic implantation techniques: the mechanical alignment, the anatomical alignment, and the adjusted mechanical alignment techniques. There are two personalized implantation techniques: the functional alignment and the kinematic alignment techniques. The restricted kinematic alignment concepts correspond to the kinematic alignment technique and only apply for a fraction of patients with severe limb deformity or jointline obliquity. So let's start with the mechanical alignment. The goal is to create a straight limb with a perpendicular jointline. The implants are aligned on the long bone mechanical axis perpendicular to it. When performing MATKA, most of patients have a severe alteration of their knee anatomy, which generates frequent knee imbalance that need to be corrected with a soft tissue release. With the adjusted mechanical alignment technique, the goal is to create a prosthetic limb with a few degree residual varus deformity. This technique only applies for patients with constitutional limb deformity, the one with medial knee arthritis. The implants are aligned on the long bone mechanical axis. The tibia implant is perpendicular to it, and the femoral component is slightly 2 degree varus orientated. The anatomical alignment technique, the goal is to create a straight limb with a joint line 2 to 3 degree oblique. The implants are aligned on the long bone mechanical axis. The tibia is implanted with a 3 degree varus and the femoral component with 3 degree valgus. Anatomical is not much adequate in order to describe this technique because when performing anatomical alignment, the surgeon does not consider the individual unique knee anatomy. So in my opinion, a jointline adjusted mechanical alignment technique is more appropriate because the implant remain aligned on the long bone mechanical axis and they are slightly adjusted in order to create a slightly oblique jointline. The kinematic alignment technique is the physiological way to implant TKA. The goal is to preserve the constitutional limb alignment and jointline obliquity. The implants are aligned on the knee kinematic axis. Some surgeons would argue that it may also be named anatomical alignment, and I think it is sound. I do not disagree with it, because we also, in order to make the cut, we refer to the articular surfaces. Nevertheless, as I said before, anatomical alignment is a term which has been taken 50 years ago by Unkerford and Krakow in order to describe that technique. So it may be confusing to use this word for kinematic alignment. So when performing kinematic implantation, there are some patients with severe limb deformity or jointline obliquity, and you may don't want to restore this anatomy as they may be biomechanically inferior. So the restricted KA protocol or Montreal protocol has been developed around 10 years ago with alignment limits 3 degrees for the HKA and 5 degrees for the MPTA and LDFA. If you apply those limits, 20% of your patient will necessitate a restricted kinematic implantation. So when performing RKA, the implants are aligned on the, they remain aligned on the knee kinematic axis, but they are slightly, their positioning is slightly adjusted in order to reduce the deformity. Obviously, you need a technology in order to perform RKA accurately. The functional alignment is a newborn. The goal is quite similar to the restricted KA concept. The goal is to maintain to some extent the constitutional knee anatomy and to respect some limits for alignment. It is the implants are not systematically aligned on an axis because implant positioning is defined by a sophisticated process that accounts for the individual limb and knee anatomy and knee soft tissue behavior. So in order to perform FA, you need technology, either a navigation or robotic system that allow you to do an intra-op 3D planning in order to assess dynamic or functional alignment and soft tissue balance. So regarding the UK implant, it is follows the same principle. So for the uni, you have two main techniques, the K and the MA. So mechanically aligned uni, the goal is to perform the cut perpendicular to the long bone axis. For the KUK, the goal is to perform the bone cut parallel to the cylindrical axis. Both techniques obviously do try to preserve the constitutional limb anatomy, and none of them create knee imbalance, so there is no need for soft tissue release, of course. There are much more to come on personal arthroplasty. There is a book that will be soon published and in open access, the Personalized Arthroplasty Society, a platform to discuss clinical cases, and last, a kinematic alignment channel on YouTube and also a ViewMedi. So guys, I really hope you enjoy this talk and see you on the next video. Thanks, bye.